Cyprus, an island in the eastern part of the Mediterranean Sea, gained its independence from Britain in 1960. But it's been divided since the mid-1970s, when war broke out between the island's two main ethnic groups, the Greeks and the Turks. The continued tensions on the island have almost brought the two NATO member nations, Greece and Turkey, to war. There have been talks to try to bring the two sides of the island back together, but they haven't worked. There is one hopeful spot for reconciliation in Cyprus. It's taking place in a lab with a small group of scientists. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Livesay has the story.
Since 1974, Cyprus has been a country divided between the ethnically Greek South and Turkish North. Even today, one of the most painful aspects of the war that split the country in two is the fate of the hundreds of people on both sides who disappeared in the violence decades ago and were never found.
So this is our anthropological laboratory.
That's where Florian von Koenig and his team come in.
These are the remains of how many people?
30-plus remains on the tables.
Von Koenig is the United Nations Permanent Secretary to the Committee on Missing Persons in Cyprus. Its mission is to find and identify the remains of those missing brothers, sons, and fathers, more than 2,000 people in all, from the very old to the very young.
This was an infant.
Yes.
Approximately how old?
4 to 6 months.
3 to 6 months.
The tram on the right hip.
The Committee on Missing Persons does not attempt to assign blame or establish the cause of death, although sometimes it's obvious.
So the hip was broken?
Yes. And we are thinking it's a gunshot wound.
There was a gunshot wound here. Probable gunshot wound.
Yes.
The committee is using science to bring closure to families of the missing and possibly bring the country closer to reunification.
The process starts when investigators, often retired police officers, get a tip about a possible secret, unmarked burial site. They call archaeologists to start digging. 9 teams, equally divided between Greek and Turkish Cypriots. Sometimes they find the remains of one body, other times the remains of many in a mass grave.
The more complicated things are graves like these. You have no idea how many people are here. We've had graves where we found, you know, basically only small finger bones and kneecaps, and they turned out to belong to 68 people.
Remains are brought here to labs in the neutral United Nations-controlled Green Zone in Cyprus to be cleaned and organized so identification can begin. It's a process that can take months.
The remains come here with chain of custody and with archaeological reports and recovery logs, so they show us what it was exhumed in each burial.
Including belongings,
including,
clothing.
Exactly, including non-biological artifacts.
So that includes, in this case, the soles of shoes, a house key, some
exactly.
spare
coins,
change.
Yes, yes.
Personal items like rings can be clues to identifying the victims. The lab also relies on victims' dental records and DNA to compare with samples donated by relatives of the missing. The lab staff is a reflection of the island's political division and personal loss. Greek Cypriot Theodora Eleftheru and Turkish Cypriot Amina Çatınsil both have missing relatives. 2 years ago, Çatınsil discovered one of the skeletons she was analyzing belonged to her own grandfather.
So you found your own grandfather's remains?
Yes.
By chance?
Yes, because we work blindly. I mean, we don't know who they are. And once the DNA results came, it was my grandfather.
So this is your grandfather?
Yes, and he was 34 years old when he got missing.
Her grandfather was a Turkish Cypriot civil servant who disappeared on his way home from work at a time of heightened tensions before the 1974 war. His body, found more than 50 years later, showed signs of multiple gunshot wounds.
Was it emotional?
Not while I was analyzing. After I found out that it is him, the emotional part was to tell my parents about it.
What was that like?
They were finally happy that he is found, and final acceptance that he is actually dead.
It's one of the most important parts of the process, reuniting families with the remains of their loved ones so they can have a proper burial, whether it be Christian or Muslim or non-religious.
Since 2006, the committee has identified 847 people, fewer than half of the missing. And the work being done here could help families in other conflicts around the world.
How cutting edge is the work you're doing?
So right now, we are, I believe, the biggest lab in the world that deals with skeletal remains of missing persons and does the anthropological analysis on it. We've started to train others. We focus on the Middle East region. So we've trained scientists from Iraq, where there's more than 500,000 people missing. We have trained scientists from Lebanon. We'll soon be training Syrians. So there's a lot of interest because the expertise you see here is very, very specific.
These Cypriots know their work will never be complete.
Do you think you'll recover all of them?
No. We know that we will not because we know that many burials are already under roads, under buildings. So, committee tries to do the best. But we know that some remains are lost forever.
Nevertheless, they're not giving up.
Is this a healthy process for a country that's trying to reunify, or does it actually have a negative effect sometimes?
No, I mean, we strongly believe we, in a number of ways, we contribute to reconciliation, or we remove an obstacle to reconciliation, because there are thousands of families that are directly or indirectly affected, and you know, case by case, we allow these families to find closure.
So you're not just putting the bodies back together,
No.
You're putting the country back together.
That's how we feel here, and that's why we are proud about our work.